Have you ever wondered why popular cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin struggle to handle high numbers of transactions? Or why it sometimes takes so long for your crypto payments to go through? Well, Hathor is designed to tackle these exact issues, and it does so in a pretty clever way. In this video, I am going to explain what Hathor is, how Hathor works, the architecture of the Hathor network, what nano contracts are and how they work, and finally, we are going to explore the tokenomics of the HTR token. Hathor was founded by Jan, Marcelo, Leila, Pedro and Jan, with Jan acting as their CEO. Hathor began development in 2018, with its mainnet going live in 2020. Hathor is a type of distributed ledger technology that combines elements of both blockchain and directed acyclic graph technologies. Now, I know that sounds very confusing, so let's break down some definitions first. Simply put, a blockchain organizes data into a linear chain of blocks where each block contains multiple transactions and is linked to the previous one. This structure ensures high security, but it is generally slow. On the other hand, a directed acyclic graph or DAG uses a web-like structure where individual transactions are directly linked to multiple previous transactions. This comes with higher speed and better scalability. Hathor is a hybrid platform that combines both technologies. To give a quick analogy, imagine Hathor as a super efficient highway system. Traditional blockchains like Bitcoin are like a one-lane road. They can only handle so much traffic before things start to slow down. Hathor, on the other hand, is like a highway that can automatically add new lanes when traffic increases. This flexibility allows it to handle way more transactions without slowing down. So, how does it actually work? In Hathor's system, there are two types of structures, blocks and transactions. Blocks are similar to traditional blockchain blocks. They are mined through proof of work and form a chain. Transactions, on the other hand, form a directed acyclic graph in which each transaction confirms at least two previous transactions. This creates a web-like structure that allows for parallel processing and greater throughput. Here's where it gets interesting. Both blocks and transactions require proof of work, but transactions have a much lower difficulty than blocks. Under proof of work systems, miners, which is a fancy way to say computers, compete to solve a complex mathematical problem, with the first miner to solve the problem getting rewarded with newly minted cryptocurrency. In the case of transactions, users aren't rewarded, but they contribute to network security every time they make a transaction. Think of it like this. Blocks are like big trucks carrying around heavy loads on the highway. Transactions are like smaller cars zipping around on side streets. Both contribute to overall traffic flow, but in different ways. In times of low activity, blocks do most of the heavy lifting for security and confirmation. It's similar to how Bitcoin operates. But when network activity increases, the higher the number of new transactions, the faster the transactions are confirmed. This approach means Hathor can scale to handle massive transaction volumes when needed without sacrificing security during low volume periods. All of these elements come together to create a network that's flexible, scalable, and secure, and that's exactly what makes Hathor different from other DAG-based cryptocurrencies. Now, let's take a look at Hathor's technical architecture, which can be broken down into five key components. As I already mentioned, the DAG layer is where most transactions live. Each transaction in the DAG confirms at least two previous transactions. This creates a web-like structure that allows for parallel processing. The blockchain layer, on the other hand, is embedded within the DAG and is a traditional blockchain. Blocks are mined through proof of work and provide high security to the network. The proof of work mechanism requires both transactions and blocks to complete proof of work, but at different difficulty levels. This distributes security across the entire network. Then we have the consensus algorithm. The consensus algorithm in Hathor combines elements of proof of work, which is used in Bitcoin, with DAG-based consensus. In general, a consensus algorithm is responsible for ensuring that all nodes in the network agree on the current state of the system and which transactions are valid. Next, the token layer. The token layer is built on top of this architecture and allows for easy creation and management of custom tokens. Let's look at how these components work together. When a user initiates a transaction, it first goes through a small proof of work process. This helps prevent spam and contributes to network security. The transaction then confirms two previous transactions in the DAG. This process continues, creating a web of confirmations that grows rapidly as more transactions are added. Meanwhile, miners are working to create new blocks. These blocks confirm one previous block and at least two transactions. This links the blockchain and DAG structures together. The consensus algorithm then determines which transactions are valid based on their accumulated proof of work and position in the DAG. All of this happens in a decentralized manner, with no central authority controlling the process. This architecture allows Hathor to achieve some impressive technical specs, including a theoretical throughput of 200 plus transactions per second, near instant transaction confirmations during high activity periods, and the ability to scale further as network usage grows. It's a complex system, but the end result is a cryptocurrency that aims to provide the best of both blockchain and DAG technologies. Now that we know exactly how Hathor works, let's talk about one of Hathor's most innovative features, Nano Contracts. Nano Contracts are Hathor's approach to smart contracts. They are designed to be lightweight, efficient, and easy to use. A smart contract is simply a self-executing digital agreement on a blockchain that automatically executes when specific requirements are met. For example, send this NFT from wallet A to wallet B only when wallet B has successfully deposited X amount of funds to wallet A. Of course, smart contract use cases go beyond NFTs, such as token swaps, real estate, etc. Generally speaking, smart contracts are very difficult to program. Hathor, on the other hand, provides contract templates, making it very easy to create nano contracts on the Hathor blockchain without needing to develop their code. Because they are lightweight, nano contracts can be executed quickly with minimal resource consumption. Despite their simplicity, nano contracts can be used for many reasons, from token creation to complex decentralized applications. To deploy a typical smart contract, first you need to design it, code it, test it, audit it, and finally deploy it to the network before it can be used. Each one of these steps requires a lot of time and effort, making the entire process complex and time-consuming. On the other hand, creating a nano contract is much simpler. Instead of coding from scratch, you select a pre-existing blueprint from Hathor's catalog and then you simply customize the blueprint by setting specific parameters for your use case. This process requires only two main steps, designing and deploying it. Once deployed, the nano contract can be used immediately, ultimately saving users time from coding, testing, and auditing. The blueprint-based approach makes contract creation easy even to users without programming knowledge, while maintaining security and functionality. Now, the native token of the Hathor network is known by the market ticker HTR. 1 billion pre-mined tokens were created at the Genesis block, and their allocation was as follows. 24% went to the Treasury, 18% to the 5-year vault, 20% subjected to the burn schedule, 10% to the team, 8% to the private sale, 5% to the seed sale, 5% was given to advisors, another 5% to exchange liquidity, 3% to staking, and 2% to bounty and ecosystem. HTR can be used to pay for transaction fees on the network when they're required, it serves as the reward for miners who secure the network, and is also used for governance decisions on the network. Beyond that, HTR is designed to be a medium of exchange. Its fast transaction times and low or zero fees make it suitable for everyday payments. New HTR tokens are created through mining, similar to Bitcoin. However, the reward schedule is designed to be more gradual, with block rewards halving periodically. Now, an interesting fact that's worth mentioning is Hathor's approach to transaction fees. In times of low network activity, transactions are free, but when the network gets congested, a small fee is required. These fees are then burned, removing them from circulation. This creates a potentially deflationary effect as network usage grows, which theoretically makes HTR more valuable over time. Think of it like this. Imagine a city where roads are free to use most of the time, but during rush hour, you have to pay a small toll. That toll money isn't given to anyone, it's destroyed. The more the city grows and the roads are used, the more toll money is destroyed, making the remaining money in the city more valuable. Hathor is an innovative project that aims to solve the scalability trilemma. The trilemma claims that blockchain systems can only at most have two of the following three properties: decentralization, scalability, or security. Hathor aims to solve this by combining elements of both blockchain and DAG technologies. The key strengths of Hathor include high scalability potential with the ability to handle 200 plus transactions per second, maintain security through a hybrid proof-of-work system, decentralization by involving both miners and regular users in network security, easy token creation, various use cases, easy creation of nano contracts, and finally, a flexible fee structure that adapts to network conditions. However, it's important to note that Hathor is still a relatively young project. It faces challenges such as gaining adoption and building a robust ecosystem, competing with more established blockchain platforms and proving its scalability and security claims in real-world high-stakes scenarios. I believe that Hathor represents an interesting approach to solving one of crypto's biggest challenges, the scalability trilemma. That said, the crypto space moves quickly and there are many projects working on scalability solutions. Hathor will need to continue innovating and building its ecosystem to stand out in this competitive landscape. As always, it's important to remember that nothing is ever guaranteed in crypto, and you should always do your own research. I encourage you to dig deeper, read the technical documentation, and form your own opinions about Hathor's potential. You can find all my sources in the description below. If you enjoyed this video on Hathor Network, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and give it a thumbs up.